10, Gareth Hughes.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. To the Minister for Tertiary Education, does he stand by his statement, today's students are the future of our economy and we can't afford to get this wrong?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Mr. Speaker, absolutely.
Gareth Hughes.
To the Minister, if students are the future of our economy, why have so many students missed out on studying because universities are limiting entrance?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Mr. Speaker, it may be news to the member, but universities are always, to some degree, limited entrance, and some of them are doing so this year. What I can tell the member is that we are funding more places at both universities and polytechs this year, more core places than the country ever has before, and next year we will be doing the same, including about 6,500 more than in 2008.
Supplementary.
Gareth Hughes.
To the Minister, if students are the future of our economy, why has spending on tertiary education been cut in 2010?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Mr. Speaker, on the contrary, the spending on tertiary education is being maintained at current baseline levels. What we aren't doing is increasing the amount of tertiary education looking forward, and that's because tertiary education already takes a large and significant proportion of the government's expenditure and as a percentage of New Zealand's economic wealth compared to other countries.
Gareth Hughes.
To the Minister. If New Zealand is trying to catch Australia in wage terms, while we have cut the tertiary spend according to the Parliamentary Library, and they have increased their spend by $5.3 billion over the next 6 years.
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Mr. Speaker, as I say, the government is increasing its spend, and as a proportion of our GDP, we have a slightly higher spend than the Australians do. Our problem is not the way the cake is cut in this country. Our problem is the size of the cake. And if the member and his party would like to join with the government in looking at ways of growing the economy faster, we'd be happy to have their assistance.
Gareth Hughes.
If we want a smart and prosperous economy, why do we spend $3,000 less than the rest of the OECD on our per student average?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Mr. Speaker, again, to explain for the member's benefit, as a proportion of our economy, we spend a larger proportion on average than other countries in the OECD. Our problem is not what we spend as a proportion of what we're able to spend. Our problem is that our economy isn't big enough, and that's why the government is focused on ways of growing the economy so that we can all increase the spend on the things that we want to spend money on.
Gareth Hughes.
If students are the future of our economy, why has the minister shut the door on students who want to study, cut funding? Can New Zealand afford a Minister of Tertiary Education who gets it so wrong?
The Honourable Stephen Joyce.
Mr. Speaker, I think the member is showing the limited benefit of recording his supplementary questions before he comes to the House, because what I've told him is that we're increasing the number of full-time places at universities. Next year there will be 117,400, which is 5,600 more than in 2008, at least when I went to school.
Point of order.
Point of order. Point of order, Gareth Hughes.
Mr. Speaker, I seek leave to table a document prepared by the Parliamentary Library that shows that tertiary education funding has decreased in 2010 versus 2009.
Leave is sought to table that document. Is there any objection? There is no objection. Question number 11, the Honourable Darren Hughes.
Thank you, sir.